Okay. Am I live yet? That's the question. Am I live yet? I do not know. We're gonna. If you really want to crop it when we're in the game, you can crop it when we're in the game. Am I on stream yet? I want to show people the audio that it makes when you go onto the Wii menu thing. Are any. Okay, I guess I'm live. Guess I am. This is the sound this game makes. Look, I have nothing on my emulated Wii thing, by the way. This is the sound it makes. That's it. We're gonna play Cruisin' for the Wii. Cruisin' for the Wii is a port of the arcade game, Fast and Furious, which is itself inspired by cruising games anyway. Published by Midway on the Wii in 2000. 7 or 8, or something like that. I'm pretty sure Cruisin' is a Nintendo brand because they have another game out recently that I've been playing in the arcade, which is licensed by Nintendo. So they ported the Fast and Furious game and removed all the Fast and Furious branding, basically, because they didn't have the rights to that anymore. This game is a piece of quality work and is also ridiculously hard because it's designed for to eat your money, and they didn't really change it. I'm gonna reset my save data, and yes, there's no glitch with the stream. The sound effects only come through the left channel. That's not a problem anywhere. That's literally the game, and I'm not gonna make it mono because I really don't want to annoy you guys. So in this, we're gonna do the circuit mode, which is you have to come top three in every race. That's the problem with this. Go through all the courses. And try and beat them. Okay, timing starts in a minute. I'll tell you when it starts, actually. It's when I select my upgrade. I don't know if any of these cars are actually better than each other. But I chose the Firebird, so why not? No, that's not the emulator. This is how bad the game is. Okay, timing starts when I hit accept. So, 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, so what I didn't tell you guys about this game yet is it has horrible load times. The arcade loads in like an instant. For some reason, the Wii version takes forever. I'm gonna good 40 seconds, so I got some time to talk. I've cracked open a cold one. Oh, which something alcoholic. So I can get through this. Yeah, apparently the upgrades do barely anything. I get the spoiler, the engine, and the nitrous. Nitrous is actually useful, kind of. It pushes your top speed up. So it's not exactly a bad thing. Get some great music. Turn this up a bit. Do not adjust your sets. Any issues you're seeing are with the game, probably. Probably not the stream. Maybe the stream. Oh god. Yes, the sound effect. I get used to the sound effects only coming through one channel. So, this is a Wii game. And the only controller inputs it supports are the Wii remote. Either motion controls or the D-pad. And I'd rather use the motion. The motion controls aren't too bad, actually. The top speed you can get with this is like 145. You can go slightly faster by double tapping on. Oh, what's the daisy? On accelerate. But yeah, to build up speed quickly to get back to your top speed, I do that. Nitrous gives you a brief period of higher top speed, I'm pretty sure how it works, and also puts you up to that speed. So sometimes if you crash into something and you've slowed down a whole bunch like that, nitrous isn't too bad of a way of getting back up. Knowing me, I'm probably going to mess up a lot, which is why the estimate's somewhat high. My PB is 42 13, and that has a this is the winning at the end, so I can use my nitrous, I think. Yeah, I've ruined the race. We're nearly at the end, unfortunately. Times Square. Yeah, so if you have that happen, you crash into one thing, everyone goes past you, you're failed. You need to be top three. You can wheelie onto another car, but I don't think it really does anything. Sometimes it just slows you down. And that's how long it takes to reset. I have one track failure in my PB. That's how long it takes. Take a swig. I'm already in the red. I'm not even on the first thing yet. Luckily, I think you can do this on the arcade cabinet as well. I'm pretty sure there's a big tunes button. You can change the track, the music track, but it makes the game stutter for a second. Let's put on D&B, my favorite. There we go. It's literally called D&B. It's the whole genre. Good thing this is basically the last run of the marathon if you don't count the 12 minutes of Sonic R. Because knowing me, I'll probably go overestimate. With this game, Stuntman's a bit different. Stuntman, I feel like I actually have some sort of control. I don't know who the original devs of this game were. It's published by Raw Thrills, I'm pretty sure. But I don't remember if the devs are the same as this port. Sometimes, if you're going fast enough and you crash into a traffic car, you'll just push it out of the way. Sometimes you come to a complete stop. Really annoying. Sometimes when you do wheelies and you go over bumps, you do flips. At some points in the game, you actually have to do that. Maybe I can come first. No idea. Oh, look, where did this guy come from? Ah, sick finish. I think I came first. Sorry, at least third. Pretty sure I came third. Okay. The game's gonna make me enter my name at least once. There's a dev name on the beginning, but I didn't see who it was. Also, this takes forever to skip. What's your name? My name is A. Five minutes in. First track done. Gonna mash two. There we go. That's difficult, guys. Time for some more loading. Yeah, that text that pops up. Checkpoint, nitrous. How many seconds you are ahead or behind? It gets in the way so much. Yeah, at least the Wii version has widescreen. Sit up a bit. Move my chair. Might help a bit. I'm gonna relax a bit. Can I help? I don't know. Probably not. Come on, there we go. I was trying to do the wheelie properly. I wasn't accepting my input. I don't think the HUD is slightly stretched. It's not the worst stretching I've seen though. Airtime. I love this. I just noticed there is a HUD element specifically for airtime. There's one part of this track where I'm pretty sure you have to either be doing this or you have to be nitrousing to actually make it over. I'm pretty sure that's not fast to do that. It looks cool, I guess, but... Unfortunately, this is not as exciting as Stuntman is. I would ramp that thing, but I don't want to risk it. I've already failed one track. Where did that AI car go? Can you look backwards in this game? You can, I don't know what the button is. I thought it was a D-pad thing, but it's not, apparently. is this bit I was talking about. Ooh. Can I make it? See, half the AI don't make it. Oh. Where am I going? Okay, what was that? Interesting. Okay, we're going to take this shortcut. This shortcut is actually somewhat useful. That's two nitruses already wasted. Can I make this? Nope, not really. I'm going to have to use my last nitrous. Getting back up to speed here. See, I'm first now. But I won't be for long. Don't want to do that. That's the problem with doing the wheelies, is you can't tell what's in front of you. I have no nitrous anymore either. I just realized there's also total amount of damage done. I'm pretty sure I've done more than $2,000 worth of damage. Ugh, I think I came third in the end, but look at that. Look how close the AI car got to me. Yeah, I think there must be a port breaking thing. There is no look back. Good to know. Time for about a minute's worth of loads. This is Chinatown. We're still in the easy tracks, luckily. This is easy. Chat's not even active this time, that's the problem. I like the sprites don't even look any good. They all look blurry as well. I know this is a Wii game, but come on, guys. I'm doing this really, really bad. Done too much running, speed running today. Did a practice run of this, I did a practice run of Stuntman Ignition, and then I did Stuntman Ignition about 20 minutes after the practice, and then I had about an hour, like 15 minutes until I did this or something, or an hour. Oh, nice vault. We'll land back on the ground one day. One day. All I wanted to do was make sure I was at top speed. Yeah, Race Wars is a really weird name. No one notices that until I point it out. Most people don't anyway. Use nitrous because I'm on a straight. Usually I wait and hold off and don't use nitrous unless I'm in an issue where I need to use it. Because I'm pretty sure the AI just catch up with you anyway. Like, obviously the whole point of the game of a speedrun is you want to be the fast. You want to be fast anyway. I mean, going fast using the nitrous is a good idea, but usually, with me running this game, the issue is the AI beating me. I'm usually just wary of using it. I think I'm near the end, though, that's why I'm using it. But they'll catch up, even though I use nitrous. That's why you don't use it all! Needs reset. That's why you don't use it all. Chinatown. That's a sec. If this was a marathon with donations, I'd put how many. I donate like $5 every time I fail a track and have to reset. The reason. Wow, really? Nice. What is your favorite FNF movie? I've only seen 6. I get it. It's also my least favorite, but it's the only one I've seen. I was going to say something I completely forgot. Something about this game, probably. The game is so choppy when everyone's on the screen as well. Oh, the reason I'm resetting before I hit the finish line is because once you hit the finish line, you have to wait for the whole menu to appear and stuff before you can reset, and it will waste another 30 seconds or so. So usually if I'm near the end and I haven't won, I'll just reset. And the menu still has a long load time, but it's shorter. I used to fail Chinatown X, which is very near the end of the game a lot, but I figured out a way to not fail it as much, although it's still very annoying. This is when Cameron comes in and tells us how you should run the arcade version instead. I don't think anyone else has done a run of this. Maybe someone else would like to torture themselves, but, you know. Also, Raw Thrills' logo is still in this game. I just saw it. Even though they don't have anything to do with the port. I'm surprised. There it is again. Surprised. Oh, dude's spinning. Oh, there he is. So not only that dude went off of a ramp, did some spins in the air, and still landed in front of me. So you can kind of control yourself mid-air. Bit weird, though. I don't think... Oh yeah, I haven't used any nitrous yet at all. Just need to watch out for traffic cars. That's usually my issue. Yeah, third. Good enough. You can tell what I mean by they haven't adjusted it from the arcade. This is designed to eat your money. Because I'm pretty sure with the arcade version, if you get a first, you get a free game. So, arcade... You know... Arcade, what's the word? People who run the arcades lose money if you win. So they don't want you to win, but with this game, I have bought it with my money already, and no one loses money if I lose. Therefore, they should have adjusted it. And for Malibu, this one's a bit tricky. Because some of the parts of the track are really thin. And tight turns that you don't really see coming up. Anyone want to talk about anything in particular? Like Sonic R, that's apparently the last run of the marathon was meant to be me with driver parallel lines, but we moved it so it could be a race with BPG, and then BPG didn't want to do the race, so I did it with Taduva. That was... not too far into the beginning of the marathon, I guess, like 6 hours in, I think we 4 hours in. 4 hours in. Not battle round. Pretty sure that's called in-app purchases. Woohoo! Because, you know, cruising as a mobile game, to play the track, you have to buy an in-app purchase. I bet you there's racing games that are like that, though, so don't give Nintendo any ideas. They'll release a version of Cruisin' on the mobile. But here, to make it over this properly, you have to be wheeling. Okay, that didn't slow me down too much. The cars that spawn here are random, I'm pretty sure, also. I'm gonna use my nitrous here. I was meant to do a flip there, but it didn't work, I guess. Also, this thing on the beach is not solid. Just drive straight through that. Also, sometimes out of the force of habit, I do wheelies, even if it doesn't actually make me any faster. Also, these are all licensed cars, right? It's funny, in the game with this crap. They kept the rights for the cars, but not the movies. You think the cars would be more expensive? No. No! Sometimes I wish you could do the flinging thing on console. I tried some ideas, but it never really worked out. Oh, I don't have any more nitrous. Somehow I made it into second, nice. Yeah, I know about driving up the hills, but I've never bothered to. There's half the times I've taken shortcuts and it ends up making me go slower.
Central Park.
Central Park next. This is when you actually start unlocking tracks. Yeah, we all go to our deaths in the ocean. Only 5 minutes behind.
Central Park.
With like two race failures, I think, so far. Okay, now for Central Park, which mostly doesn't take place in Central Park. It's like half Central Park, half, I'm guessing, New York, where Central Park is, right? It's the one that's in Tri of a Parallel Line, so I probably should know it. That was an interesting one, thanks to the iRacer. Oop, that kind of worked, but not really. The shortcut kind of worked, but then I went off the ramp really badly. These AI. Nice bikes. I don't know why those guys go down that way when this is like a straight path. I guess because of the hill. It's an hour out of the park. Is this the level with the subway in it? I think it is. That's a good part of the level. You'll see what I mean when we get to it. Up the speed. Okay, we're gonna do a flip over this one, nice. And this one. Apparently. And this one, apparently. I'm gonna use my nitrous just to push my speed up a bit more. Okay, so here's the subway. You know why the subway is really good, right? Not because of that, but because there's traffic in the subway. There are cars down here driving on the tracks. Now, that's not a port issue. That happens in the in the arcade version as well. I'll use the last nitrous, I guess. I don't feel like this is a loss. Also, I'm gonna lose. Well, there's only a checkpoint. Got a little bit of time left. Also, how can you knock down the things supporting the subway and not have it fall down? Okay, we're good. There we go. I think that was third. Yes, that is third. Lost.jpg. So yeah, that's what subway is for, right? The train tracks for the cars. Oh, it's FNF drift. Nice.
Ghetto.
Time for the ghetto.
Engine. LA ghetto.
Why does she say that so weirdly? It's weird, I saw someone complain that the tutorial voiceover for Onrush was trying too hard to seduce them, and it's like, have you played Cruisin'?
LA ghetto. Engine. Automatic.
There you go. Give me a VO job, please, thanks. Good thing you linked an image that I can't look at. Oh, I guess I could look at it during loading screens. Let's change the track. I don't want to listen to that. Yeah, let's listen to this again. This track is interesting. The bit where you actually get to like the I forgot what they're called now. The drains. It's really weird. There's also some really weird shortcuts in this game. In this track, sorry. And I don't really know if they're actually faster, but I'm going to take them anyway. So you think, you're meant to turn on this corner, right? No, you don't need to. You can just do this. Smash straight through the cement. Same with this one. I don't want to... The thing is, you vault over as soon as you touch these people. This is not one, because this is actually a turn into the sewers. You can go on the left and right of the sewers like this. It's not really that good. Although I guess I could do a bit of boosting here, but it's so slow. I keep falling off, getting caught on everything. It's not worth it. Not a shortcut unless you're ridiculously skilled at cruising for the Wii, which no one is. Luckily, we get to a big open bit in a second. I don't know which way this is faster, but whatever. Also, something like that here. You can crash through that whole thing, by the way. It doesn't matter. I'm going to use some nitrous here, I think. Oh no, the police helicopter's after us. For an illegal street race through the sewers.
No, come on.
Yes, we're good. That's my stress voice. What is that an image of? Should I click it? That's the question. Or am I going to throw up if I click it? Can we ever have a mod check this image, please? The sound of constipation. Oh, me. Golden Gate. Have a look at this image. Also, I need to skip this. Oh, that's interesting. That's a lot of spoilers you have on your car. I'll just do tires. Usually I did spoiler, but whatever. No, all the spoilers on that car. I think Nissan should sue. This is a good track. It has a good shortcut. I think Golden Gate. Yeah, this has a good shortcut. A really good shortcut. I don't know if that's great or sad, Cameron. And it was a game that meant something. Instead of this game. I bet he's upgraded every car in this game as well. Or PC, the arcade version anyway. Don't want to listen to that. Let's listen to this again. I like the sound of this... This ground makes as you run over it. Checkpoint. Come on, wheelie then. There's a few, minor shortcuts here. Or like on this bridge. You're meant to like go down to the bottom in that way, but you can also jump across to the top. And then have this happen anyway. Probably shortcuts on these tracks I'm missing that Cameron is going to tell me off for. Here's another one of these, by the way. Oh, good collision. At least it didn't bump me and stop me. Okay, here's the good shortcut. This is a really good shortcut. This is probably the best shortcut in the game. Coming up. Just forget all walls of this. Fuck. Can I turn around? Now, that is so annoying. I really want to show that shortcut. Oh, that's sad. I bigged it up too much. Anyway, basically the shortcut. You go across the tops of buildings and across thin air. that has a collision, apparently. And you don't have to do all these windy turns. You can crash through everything, and it usually puts you first. Fortunately, I'm only third. Fourth now. I can use nitrous anyway. Maybe I'll have to redo this track, and I can show you. Because this ain't going so well. Because the ending is along this bridge. Yeah. Can we get a first? No. We'll get one first in this whole run. Maybe. Pretty annoying. I wanted to show that. Slight spoiler. Why not? Time for New England. Old England was too bad, so America created its own version. Time for loud noise. There we go. You finished a can of cider in like the loading screens and it's goddamn. I rented this game for a week. I'm pretty sure I didn't keep it longer than that. The first time I played it anyway. For some reason I rented it. I think I rented it at the same this is not a joke against the sensitive topic. I'm pretty sure I rented it at the same time I rented a movie that's called Wrist Cutters, A Love Story. That's actually an alright movie. It's a black comedy about, it's based off a book, a short story called Nella's Happy Campers. It's about people, it's basically when people kill themselves, they go to an afterlife that is the same as the real world, but they're always sad. It's actually really good. I recommend it. I think I rented it the same time I rented this game, because I went to a specific library to rent it. Oh, there's a shortcut there I was meant to take. Cameron's gonna rage in chat. Yeah, I don't know why they chose that name, because I guess it makes more sense than Nella's Happy Campers, because Nella's Happy... okay, that's not a spoiler. Nella's Happy Campers is kind of a spoiler, because it's, like, you don't come across Nella until, like, halfway through the movie or something. But I guess it was a short story, so it doesn't matter. Good movie. I haven't watched it in a very long time. It's a really sensitive topic to talk about during cruising. I know, and now I'm not paying attention. Choose some nitrous. Our high school library actually had the book that the short story is in, but I never rented it. Which I mean high school. This area is really annoying. Like, there's a shortcut there through a barn and it slows you down so much that it isn't even a shortcut. Okay. We're near the end of New England, so I want to pay attention. No. Out of the way. I'm not meant to be wheeling. Well, two-wheeling. I hate two-wheeling, as you learned earlier. Do I have a... I was going to say, I'll put it up to my webcam, but I don't have a webcam on, do I? I'm treating this like my own stream, and I shouldn't be. Yeah. That's a really weird movie to say the title of, because it just sounds like... It sounds like a... Before clickbait was a thing, an edgy title.
Hollywood.
Oh yeah, actually the main part of the story is there's people in this afterlife and they have to go find a you know, they're always sad all the time, and then someone is hears like a rumor that there's this dude who, you know, like a cult that, you know, would be able to send them back to the real world. Why is this a link to? I have time, that's the funny bit. Why do you keep linking these? Oh yeah, we're onto the extreme tracks now. This is the hardest difficulty. I mean, I don't really know how you come back from being dead, but you know. I think that was in my, that might have been in the, either a Discord or the Race Against Time Discord. Was that in our chat? I said, he was dead, but he got better, which is the tagline for Crank High Voltage. I love that tagline. Also, when is Crank 3? Unless it's already out and I haven't noticed. But they'd probably put a lot of money into that. But... thanks, Pesuto. Born again. Oh, it was in chat, was it? Okay, that's probably when I was talking about... Oh, we were watching the trailers for Stuntman Ignition. I used to watch a lot of independent movies and not a lot of mainstream. And no, I wasn't the hipster teenager. I just liked doing that. I've already joked about a lot on stream how about 13 and how the so 13 was a movie that was released about a very similar time to 13 the video game, and the American box art for 13 has the word 13 on it in very, very similar font to the movie, and the movie is about teenagers and drugs and shit, and the game is about you waking up with amnesia and apparently assassinating the president. I think they're two different topics. This bit of the race is difficult, and I need to pay attention. This is the end. It has this weird ass windy road that you do jumps over, but you don't really wind down the road. Oh my god. Can we be first, please? Yes. Yes, we get Trophy Girl. He jumps about a lot. Down for Crank 3, and it's expensive, all fucked up. Nice, yeah. Crank 3 has been... Oh, we're going to do it for ages. Oh, they're good movies. I mean, if they're a bit... They're the words of mindless fun. I know Crank isn't an independent movie, by the way. That was a different... Someone else went, oh, this movie exists. Ah, sounds a bit violent, but I'll watch it. And I watched it and I liked it. SF Free Game. The Free Game pops out of my CD drive. I only watched it once, but I watched a movie called The Whackness. That's another independent movie. The difference is, it's an independent movie. The main star... is Josh Peck. If you don't know who Josh Peck is, he is one half of Drake and Josh. Yeah, he was in some teenager, more mature, independent movie. Thought it was alright. It had that girl in from Juno, the Juno's friend. That's all I remember about it. It's been ages since I watched that movie. Yeah, you can see why I talk about random shit on my stream, because there's nothing else to talk about. Kona ever wants me to shut up, I will. It's not as bad as when Dark Viper does his GTA marathon runs and he talks about politics. Because that's this track is actually somewhat hard. I failed it a lot earlier. So I have to pay attention a bit. Sometimes there's some. Why is that cop AI cars driving across the grass? Also, this looks like it's shorter, but I'm pretty sure it's not. I'm still sick. There's a shortcut coming up, but I don't know if I should take or not, because I'm pretty sure it's not even shorter. I'm probably not going to. It's that jump, the one straight ahead. Because no one else takes it. Ever. I've never seen an AI car take it. And I've never seen it put me really any higher than the place I was already in. And I'm in third, so... I don't think Josh Peck dies during that movie. Unless you're making a joke about something else. Also, here's the end. What's that windy road called in San Francisco? Because we just went over the top of it and didn't even go down it in a racing game. Like, one of the first missions in Driver San Francisco makes you go down that road. This is going alright, but I've probably cursed that now. There's a shortcut here. And see, it's to the right, but I never take it because it's so unreliable for me. That pushes my top speed a bit higher, right? Come on. Can we get first again? Nah, second. He does? It's a bit of a spoiler, but it's an old movie that probably only no one's watched. I didn't even know that. What? How's he? What? He's like a. What's the story of that movie? I've got an advert card for it because it was in my case of my special edition DVD of Kid Adulthood. Because it's the same publisher in the UK. That's how I found out about it. And then BBC showed it once, so I watched it on TV. I love someone else in this chat. In this small chat, someone else has watched this movie. I'm guessing it helps that Josh Peck was in it. It's like why has everyone watched Spring Breakers? And it's like, because it has those Disney stars in it. That was really annoying. I went to the cinema to see The Wackness. Because, you know, I actually want to see the movie. And because it's... I forget who the director is of that. He directed Kids. And it's like, the cinema was packed. And they all came probably because they were Disney stars. And it really was annoying because I think some dude sitting next to me was moaning all the time. And I was like, shut the fuck up. I want to watch this movie. It's like an 18 though in the UK, so it's not like the kids were going to see it or anything. It's got Vanessa Hudgens and similar. I can't say her word anymore. Selena Gomez. That's it. Yeah, I have gone into random talk now. That was quite popular though, probably because they were pushing the. These are Disney stars and they're doing adult stuff, Monica. That's probably what the marketing were doing. And I'm pretty sure by the end of the movie, like, I'm pretty sure one of them drops out, like, a quarter into the movie. Because she doesn't want to put up with that life. There's, like, some... That dude whose name I forgot, that actor who plays, like, is he a drug dealer or something? This corner's really weird. It makes you get really slow. Oh, no. He's in a load of other movies. I can't remember what his name is anymore. And he, like, yeah, makes them do messed up shit or something. Not in that way, but in the crime way. That sounds really weird. A Race Against Time is a family-friendly marathon, guys. Sorry. James Franco, yeah, that's that guy's name. He's in a lot of other comedies as well, isn't he? This is the bit I hate about this course. If you go through the middle there, you slow down a lot. And for a while, I thought this course was pretty much unbeatable because of that. You need to keep your speed. This is the worst bit, so I'm going to be silent. I have two nitro left. You can see what I mean. Come on, come on, come on! Yes! Good. Yeah, you can see how, like, easy it is to nearly lose this. Cats getting eaten on piano Britney Spears covers. Oh yeah, there was a piano Britney Spears cover in it, wasn't there? I don't remember what other independent movies. I mean, I said I watched... Adulthood, but that's a British thing. I'm saving time here, by the way, against my splits, because I PB was quite bad, but I failed that. Let's just take a spoiler. This is the last track, Mulholland Drive. This is mostly easy. The end is the worst part. Track. Are my wheels dollar signs? I don't think they are, unfortunately. Or are they? I didn't know. I didn't look. Win the race by crashing into a pole at 100 miles an hour? Yeah, of course. I hope you've enjoyed my chat about independent movies and what else I was talking about. Next up, we've got Sonic R. In which you'll hear talk about how Nimputz is looking forward to Team Sonic Racing. And how it's not a sequel to Sonic R, even though it uses the same R logo. Because Sega really liked to tease. I might take a shortcut here. It's a good shortcut. It has a really good jump. It's right at the start of the track. So, that reminds me. I watched Kidulthood. Kidulthood is good. Adulthood is good. And then, ages later, Noel Clark apparently released Brotherhood, and I didn't watch it, and apparently it's not very good. Maybe I'll watch it one day, and then dude who starred in those movies released Anotherhood, and then and I was going to watch that movie, but then apparently that star was harassing Noel Clark so much, Noel Clark had to put a restraining order on him. So that kind of... The guy's funny, but it's like, what the fuck? I think you can go down the side of the track then. Did we do that shortcut, by the way? Did I do that shortcut? I was too zoned out talking about movies. Yeah, the one where, like, you do a flip onto the track. It's like, really... Shortcuts. Team Sonic Racing. Here's a shortcut I want to take. Because it's really good. Cuts out a load of twisty turns. Any other independent... my wheels are dollar signs because I upgraded them. Yeah. Be Kind Rewind, but I don't think... Does Be Kind Rewind count as an independent movie? That's a good movie. I should watch that at some point again. The one with Jack Black, yeah. Because, I mean, Jack Black, so is it independent? But I guess not. I guess it is because it's... That movie kind of has a sad end, but... It's kind of a happy in this. It's weird. It was a real big fad or online at the time because the whole concept of the movie is that they were remaking movies with whatever they had on hand, and they basically made a whole thing as like, hey, if you do this at home, we'll feature them on somewhere. And I watched those for ages. People actually did it themselves. I watched one of Monsters, Inc. Someone redid Monsters, Inc. with live actors. It was quite good. This is the worst part of this track, by the way. It's the end. I'm going to hit Nitrous and get first place. Time Kona is now. Sorry. Be Kind Rewind. Be Kind. I have a copy of that. Hang on. There it is. This isn't a Wii World record. This is 3 minutes worse than my current PB. Unique Zoton face cam. Here it is. And you can actually see through it because it green screens. There you go. Thanks, sir, for watching. Talk about random shit. I mean, the cruising run. Next up is Sonic R. Enjoy that. Did I come first place? If I did, yeah, she jumps about a lot. Thanks for watching the marathon. Watch Sonic R and whatnot. If you love me talking random shit, don't forget to follow me. And also, don't forget to follow the marathon because I imagine there'll be more in the future. Hopefully, this run will not be in them. Thanks, guys, for watching. Hurrah.